Ugh. You know, it absolutely figures. I go through and I clear out this canyon of the frickin' vipers, and I remember something that I want to, you know, go out of my way to pick up that's gonna require me to go back south. Ugh. It was a waste of time to clean this place. Well, it was sort of a waste of time to clean this canyon out, so... I don't know. Either way, there's something nearby. Yeah, I already looted him. I can't help it. I can't help it. I mean, I really can't help it. I've got this terrible... Surprised that I didn't set that off the first time I went through the canyon. But yeah, I cannot help myself whenever it comes to looting. I double, triple check bodies and containers that I've already looked into. And I don't think that that's something too uncommon. Because I remember when Skyrim came out, a bunch of memes started popping up about how people... You know, it's like, even if the container is marked as empty, you still check inside. Pretty sure that a lot of people are guilty of that one, so... Anyways, now what I'm looking for... Let's see, it's more to the south, east, so I guess I gotta just keep following up. What? What the f- Oh, Midnight Science Fiction Feature. So I do have a mod installed that basically delays the, it delays the DLC, so you actually have to come to this, this drive-through here to start Old World Blues, so... I have discovered the Mojave Drive-In, which is why I now have the quest to you know, activate, you know, the Midnight Science Fiction Theater. But I'm not gonna do that. I have actually stumbled across that by complete accident. And for that matter, I'm not entirely certain that I will do Old World Blues. It depends on, you know, how popular and successful the series is once I've gotten far enough in, because Old World Blues is by far, just without question, it is a high-level DLC. You don't go into Old World Blues at a low level and be successful, really, because I remember going through the DLC at a high level. I think my character was, like, at level 40 at... I think it was level 40 whenever I started the DLC, and geez, the it was just kicking me to the curb. So I like I said, I don't know that I'm gonna get into it. We'll see about it, you know, as time goes on. So, Bradley Shack. Not the. Here we go. I don't recall this location really. I don't think I mean, I'm pretty certain. Oh, jeez, I'm lucky that I looked around first. Let's disable this tripwire. Disarm. There we go. Can we get the shotgun? Nope. Repair is too low. So, we got some whiskey bottles. Some crates back there. A BB gun. Not gonna take it. Sleeping bed. Ooh, hey, frag grenades. Alright, this is perfect. We got some caps as well. Ammunition. I don't have the space in my pack for this stuff, so a very easy med kit, so I'll go ahead and plunder this. There we go. Mentats, Psycho, Bobby Pins, Radex, Stimpak, just basically everything that doesn't have a weight. I'll take the purified water while I'm at it, just because. I don't think that there's anything else really for me to take. I could check the sacks. Maize, nope, don't need it. Cactus fruit and some more maize, don't need it. Interesting little poster they got there. The refrigerator is empty. Well, broken open, really. The crates are empty as well. You know what I think I'll do? I'll take a nap to heal myself up, restore some things. And, well, actually, let me check my stats here. Sleep. Let's go ahead and have a full sleep to alleviate that. Let's take 2 hours. Should be more than enough. Let's head back outside. This, the Bradley Shack is not what I was looking for. Can I cook anything at this fire here, though? Nope. Nothing. Coyote Tobacco Chew. Okay, so that, now I know what I'm looking for to make more coffee, because I know that I have everything else that I need in my inventory to make this stuff. How far away am I? It's more so to the east at this point, so I guess I'll just have to work my way along the ridge here. What I'm looking for is a location that I found the first time through that I played in New Vegas. And, you know, like any game that you play through the first time, especially if you're not following a guide, which I'm going to be honest, I hope that you're not following a guide the first time you play through a game, because that really removes the wonderment of discovery and exploration. But first time I go through, I find this one interesting little location, and I'm like, oh my god, this is amazing. And it has a series of similar items that I absolutely love. And that's the particular reason why I'm looking for it. You'll find out what it is in a minute. Some of you who might be super, super into New Vegas and played through it, you know, gone over things with a fine-tooth comb, might know what I'm looking for. I seriously doubt most of you know or even have a clue what it is that I'm searching out right now. So, judging by the marker on my compass there, I think that I'm right on top of it, though. So, come over this ridge. Yep, this is the place, all right. And this must be the safe house. I'm not going to gain access to this place, probably. Caesar's Legion safe house. Yep. So there's that. And if I keep going down the road here, well, not really the road, but just over the hill, I will also find this little bunker up here. I don't think that there's anyone around here for me to kill. Here we go. This is what I was looking for. Authority glasses. Oh yeah, check this out. Check me out. Now I'm a whole lot more badass. And I've got the Four Eyes perk, so there's a whole lot of reason to be wearing these things as well. Let's go ahead and pick these up off the chair so I can repair the ones that I have on my face at any point. Oop, whoops. Okay, I'll go ahead and I'm lucky they didn't go flying. Sometimes whenever you sit down on a seat, the things sitting on top of it will just, you know, bug out and shoot across the world. There are some particularly irradiated ghouls down. There we go. Fixed up the glasses. There are some particularly irradiated ghouls down on the blasting range that I'm not going to bother with. I might come back to take a closer look, but for now, that's everything. I'm going to go ahead and go back, hit the road, and make my way up to Novak and get myself a freaking safe house. The Bighorners are marked as red. That's a bit of a surprise for me. Bighorners that are easily aggravated. I don't know. I don't see a whole lot of wild bighorn, so I'm a little bit used to them being passive aggressive instead of outright aggressive. And you know what? Instead of going straight back to the road, I think I'm just going to keep plodding my way over the top of the mountain here. Well, sure, not really a mountain, small hill. Hilly terrain or mountainous terrain? How exactly would you call that? Not entirely certain myself. There's something else on my compass over here, though. I don't know. Because New Vegas is so ridiculously dependent on questing and forcing you into a linear path, I've never really gone through a lot of trouble to explore. Because, well, I hesitate to say this because I know that there are going to be a lot of people who will get angry at me for making this statement, but let's see what we got in here. 9mm rounds and flamer fuel. No point. Not enough space in my pack. I hesitate to say this, but New Vegas, the world is just so dead. It really is. It's a dead world. There's no point in any of the locations if a quest doesn't bring you there. What do you have? Wolfhorn Ranch. Oh, okay. And this is really the big difference between Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. Place seems to be abandoned here. And actually, this plays into it. This place is abandoned. What purpose does this location have? None. None whatsoever. It just seems to be an abandoned ranch. As opposed to what, say, what you would find if you found a ranch in Fallout 3. Which, you know, they do exist. There are farms across the Capital Wasteland in Fallout 3. And what happens whenever you come across those farms? Well, they look deserted, but the more you look around, the more you find that there are these little stories in the world design. The world design itself. They're not sitting there screaming, "Look at me! There is a story here! Pay attention!" Banana, yucca, fruits. I'm lucky that there's a Kayup tobacco chew here for me to take. But in Fallout 3, there are these little stories. They're there. They exist. And if you are paying close enough attention, you can get some information about what was going on at the location. And I really, really like that. That is storytelling through world design, okay? Kind of like how Dark Souls and Demon Souls have, you know, actually some pretty interesting lore that's told entirely through the items that you pick up. Same thing with Fallout 3. There are very interesting little stories that are being told all over the place just with the world design and the way things are laid out. Ooh, a Tumblr's Today magazine. Or a skill book. Doesn't look like there's much anything. I don't know that there's anything that I'm going to be able to take out of this place. But as I was saying, that's the deal with Fallout 3. There's a whole lot of stuff going on like that. There are several instances. I mean, a good example, in my Fallout 3 play, I stumbled across a bathroom stall where there was a robot sitting on a toilet. And in the toilet, there was, you know, scrap metal in the toilet that robot was sitting on. That is a joke. That is a form of storytelling through world design, okay? You don't get that here in New Vegas. There we go. And I really don't know what to say. New Vegas really does focus on the people, the NPCs, and the missions that are immediately given to you for you to perform, okay? And that is its strong point. It focuses on crafting and the game mechanics and the quests that you are given, okay? In Fallout 3, not so much. Fallout 3 is more about ambience. Fallout 3 is more about, you know, paying attention to the world. It is about exploration. It is about atmosphere. Okay, yeah, we can take this back road up. I could travel further east over the bridge there to just keep going to a crossroads. I think to Camp Searchlight is where I would end up going before I would head north. And this seems to be a bit lucky. There's a trader on the road here. I can go ahead and sell my stuff off. I think this is the same trader that I saw over at Mojave.
Hey there. Need anything?
That's why I'm here. Let's do business.
Sure. Here's what I got.
Lucky me that I found him. All right, so my pack's a bit lighter now.
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count on that.
You guys all say the same thing. Despite the fact that... Oh, boy. There's about to be a shootout. I don't think I want to have anything to do with it. My pack, even though it's lighter, it's not super light. I'm still loaded down with lots and lots of junk, and it's none of my business. It's none of my business. Just keep walking. But yeah, my pack, even though it's lighter, I'm still weighted down with a lot of junk. That's really more or less useful predominantly for crafting, which means that I really, 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 really need to find myself a safe house. And I'm just down the road from Novak now, so I can go ahead and do what I need. I'm not deviating at all. I don't think that there are any major roadblocks between me and my destination either, so. But what was I saying a while back? Oh, that's right. The fact that world design versus quest. But yeah, that's a big, big factor about... Oh my god, more of these vipers. I didn't know that there were so many. Here I say that there are... Jeez, one of them's got a freaking rifle. Grenade rifle. I think I killed them all, except for this one over here. Let me get rid of him. Hey, pal, you ready? Eat dynamite. There we go. Got rid of him. And there's a mole rat behind me. I'll just take this thing out. Ooh! Hey, level up. Sweet. Didn't expect that to happen. Okay, so, just take everything that I've got off of him since I've got space. Okay, so, I'm still in combat, evidently. That's why I'm not leveling up. Bobby pin as well. Where's this last guy? Oh, he's over there. Oh god, he's stuck inside of a rock again. You've gotta love New Vegas. Alright. I can't vats him. And I've learned well enough from my experience out at that find me. I'm already here, man. I've learned well enough from my experience at that viper nest at the patrol station a ways back that it's not worth it. I'm just going to keep walking, and I'll level up whenever I level up. So many interruptions. It's really hard to hold one solid train of thought. But yeah, like I was saying, New Vegas is more about, you know, the quests that you get and the people that you can talk to. So as a result, the world itself doesn't really have any story to tell. Whew. Ranger Station Charlie. Well, I'll just leave this place alone. Still in caution mode. I'll probably get the level up screen any minute now. And I know that there's a doctor over in Novak, so I'm not going to waste any of my doctor's bags or anything like that right now. I'll hold on to them for whenever. Oh, here we go. Welcome to level 6. Okay, so the first thing that I got to improve is my repair skill, get this up to 45. And like I said, I'm trying my best not to be a repair character, but you know, you just can't get around that for this perk that I want. I'll increase explosives as well, put the rest into barter. So those two skills are at a very, very nice level. That should be everything that I need. Now to take the perk that I'm really after, the one that I really, really want. This is from Gunrunner's Arsenal. It's called Mad Bomber. Your intimate knowledge of gadgets and explosives has combined to make you the Mad Bomber. At workbenches, you have special explosive recipes unlocked for use. So we'll take that. Takes repair and explosives, 45 each. There's one rank of it. Bit of a shame that I won't be able to take Demolitions Expert here, but there will be levels at, later on down the line that will make where I'll be able to take Demolitions Expert. But Mad Bomber. Now playing an explosives character is going to be significantly easier, and I'll be able to, you know, get away from using the dynamite that I've got in my pack, because now I'm going to be able to craft some really, really, really super useful and seriously cheap explosives, and I'll be able to make scads of basically makeshift grenades and whatnot. There are all sorts of things. I'm super excited to use this because I've never played an explosive character before, and this is going to be my first time to use the Mad Bomber perk. But it looks really, really fun. It's like the number one thing that comes out of the GRA downloadable content. So, gonna be super useful. Here I am in Novak, finally. Looks like we got a dead Brahmin in the pen. A rotting Brahmin corpse. Nothing on it. Okay. Now, where's the doctor? I want to find the doctor first of all, because I want to heal my cripples. Looks like she's, I think this is her right over here. Guards?
Between you and me, I don't think she studied at an accredited institution.
Hello.
She hasn't paid me anything yet. Should I be worried?
Possibly. Ada?
What can I do for you?
I need help, Doc. I'm hurt.
That's not so bad. I'll have you looking as good as new. I mean, what are the chances of me botching another routine procedure in the same day?
I don't have a choice. Here's the 50 caps. Do it.
All right. I'll just get my scalpel here. And, did I leave that sitting outside? Well, you know what? Free tennis shot.
So reassuring. Ooh-wee. Okay. Where do I start? Victor? What are you doing here?
Well, butter my butt and call me a biscuit if it ain't my old friend from Good Springs.
Victor, what on earth are you doing in Novak?
Don't rightly know. I just got the notion to make my way to New Vegas. Reckon I'll find out when I get there.
You said that the men that jumped me were headed this way, right?
No, don't believe I did. But you might ask around. The Novak folk usually see anyone traveling this way.
Right. I'll see you later, Victor.
Be seeing you.
Something's wrong with this robot. Let's back away slowly. Don't make eye contact. Because he has eyes to make contact.
The salvage business has really slowed down since those ghouls took over at Repcon.
Ooh. Okay, so there are problems to solve around here. Not like I didn't know that, but still. So, let's talk to Jeannie Mae here in Dino Delight, because I need a frickin' safe house. It is really dark in here. What is going on?
Well, welcome to you. You look tired from the road. Why don't you relax a spell? Let this fine town take care of you.
I'm sorry, we haven't met yet.
Oh, what am I doing? I got to thinking about making a good impression and plain forgot to tell you my name. I'm Jeannie Mae. I take care of folks here at the motel, long as they aren't troublemakers.
Oh, well, what can you tell me about the place, then?
We're in a little desert oasis, name of Novak. This is the Dino Delight Motel, and it's mine.
So, is there anything going on in town?
Well, let's see. Dusty McBride's been losing some Brahmin, but that's probably the heat more than anything. Honestly, it's been real quiet. Ranger Andy's still hurt, but we got these two gentlemen snipers watching the road day and night, keeping the trash out of Novak. They've been a blessing.
Oh, if that's all for events, is there anything else that's of interest around here?
Well, there's Dinky, the town mascot. He's a sight. You probably already saw him when you came in, but you can go up inside, too. Up the road a ways to the west, there's Repcon. That's the old rocket factory. There's been some sinister characters out there lately, so you may want to stay clear. Other than that, nothing to do but take it easy and enjoy good company.
Anything else?
Well, up north a ways, you'll see a big tower. That's Helios 1. Used to be a power plant in its day. And there's a town just east of here called Nelson. Used to be such a quaint little place until those slavers took it over. But we got our wonderful snipers keeping an eye in that direction, and so far, the slavers have left us alone.
Oh, seems pretty quaint. By the way, I'm looking for a man in a checkered coat. Have you seen anyone like that?
Well, he might have been wearing a fancy outfit, but he wasn't any kind of gentleman to me. Had his nose stuck so high in the air you couldn't see it above the clouds. City folk. They always think they deserve better than what they got. Those hoodlums he was with seemed to know Manny for some reason. He's our daytime sniper, up in the dinosaur's mouth.
Is that so? I'll have a talk with him. I'd like to rent a room.
Well, I think that's a fine idea. I'll give you a good flat rate, and you can stay as long as you like. At least until the busy season comes. Sound good?
Sounds like a fine deal. Here's 100 caps.
I'm glad you can stay with us. Your room will be the one upstairs, closest to the lobby side. Here's your key. Let me know if there's anything I can do to make your stay better for you.
One other thing. Where can I resupply?
Go see Cliff Briscoe at the Dino Bite gift shop and tell him I sent you.
Hey, Cliff, time to have a chat with... Jeez! It is really dark in here. I'm gonna need to check some of my mods, I think.
Welcome to the Dino Bite gift shop. My name's Cliff. If you're here for the T-Rex figurines, you're just in time. There's still a few left.
Oh. Okay. Jeannie Mae sent me.
Bless her. Seems like every traveler I get in here tells me the same thing. They see the sign and think, gift shop? That's just too good to be true. But Jeannie Mae always points them back in my direction. Well, a friend of Jeannie's is a friend of mine, and my friends get a discount at my store.
Oh, thanks. In that case, what do you have to sell?
Well, there's T-Rex figurines, of course. That's our bread and butter. We also have an assortment of the Repcon factory souvenirs, rockets, things of that nature.
What about supplies and guns? You sell those?
Guns? I guess I might have a few. Darn it, no one ever buys the T-Rexes.
Well then, let's do business.
Sure thing. Have a look.
Thanks, Cliff. That's all I needed.
Come back soon now.
All right. So, let's look into this sniper that Jeannie talked about.
What's going on, man?
I didn't expect to find anyone up here. Who are you?
I'm Manny. I'm on security detail here. You see a rifle barrel sticking out of the dinosaur's mouth, you got a 50-50 shot it's me. Otherwise, it's Boone.
Boone?
Boone's a sniper, same as me. Used to spot for him when we were enlisted with the NCR. After we got out, I talked him into settling down here. So, here we are. I'd introduce you, but, we're not so friendly right now.
Really? Why would you be on bad terms with your friend?
Me and his wife, we didn't see eye to eye on some things. We had some pretty big arguments. One day, she turns up missing, and he hasn't said a word to me since.
What did you and his wife argue about?
Man, you name it. See, I grew up in North Vegas, me and my cousins. We were some bad seeds. Got in with a gang, I loved it. Then something happened, and I couldn't handle it anymore. So, I enlisted, earned my future, brought down my best friend to share that future with me. And here was this woman, who was too good for it, trying to take him away. So yeah, I didn't see eye to eye with the bitch.
Oh, wait, you were in a gang? Before you enlisted. Were they tough?
Were they tough? I was in the cons, man. It doesn't get any badder.
The cons? There were cons traveling with a man I'm looking for. He was wearing a checkered coat. Know anything?
Sure I know him. What do you want with him?
Let's just say I'm looking for answers.
Must be something pretty important to be chasing a guy like that. Well, listen, I can definitely help you find him, but I've got problems of my own. Maybe we can do a trade. You need my help. There's something I need, too.
You've had your needs neglected for far too long, haven't you? I can tell.
Yeah, everybody depends on you, you know? But they don't ask you about how you feel, what you worry about. There's something I like about you. You just seem really understanding. I was gonna ask you for a favor, but I'll just tell you what you want to know. The guy you're looking for, Benny, he was traveling with some members from my old gang. They were going to Boulder City.
Any idea why they went that way?
No clue. I know Benny hadn't paid up yet. Maybe that was where they were supposed to get square.
Oh, where is Boulder City?
It's straight up Route 93 from here. Just keep following the road north.
Oh, that's all I needed to know.
Glad I could help. Hey, I know you've got no reason to help me out now, but you seem really nice. Could I at least tell you about the problem we've got here?
Sure. Maybe I can help ease your mind.
See? I was right about you. Novak, it's home for me now. I want that to be for good. I like it here, and I've left too many homes behind. But the only resource we got here is junk. Without that, people wouldn't have anything to trade. They'd all have to leave. We get most of it up the road from the old rocket test site, but a bunch of ghouls showed up one day and took it over. We can't get in there now.
Okay, so what needs to be done?
Well, they gotta go, or this'll be a ghost town before long. It doesn't matter to me what you do. As long as the ghouls are out of there, that's good enough for me.
All right, I'll look into it for you.
It'd mean a lot to me.
Well, before I go, what was your tour with the NCR like?
Oh, it was great. I wouldn't trade it. Something about that lifestyle, the discipline, seeing new places, making people safe. What's not to like?
So, if you loved it so much, why'd you leave?
Well, I just felt like it was time, you know? Wanted to have a home. Plus, I was up at Camp Golf when Bitter Springs went down. I faked like I was sick to get out of going because I knew some of the people there. But when everybody came back, nobody would tell me what happened, and people would call us murderers sometimes when we showed up to secure towns.
What did happen at Bitter Springs?
I still don't know exactly. Just that a lot of people died who didn't want to be a part of the fighting at all. I don't blame anybody for it. There's so much chaos when you're fighting. You're lucky not to shoot your own guys. But it did take something out of it for me. This wasn't the same. So when it came time to re-enlist, I just took my papers and walked.
Somber note to end on, but I'd better get going.
Yeah, see ya.
Talk about a haul. Pretty damn lucky. I'm still amazed at how the big-ass freaking boom that the MFC... MFC grenade does. It's the first time that I'm using GRA, explosives from the Mad Bomber perk, so, I mean, I'm definitely not disappointed. Okay, here we go. This is the place that I wanted to be, before wrapping up. This is, the El Dorado gas station. I know this place by heart for one very particular reason.
Howdy.
Prospector. A little bit unusual. Carton of cigarettes. Before I, make use of this place for why I came here, though, I'm gonna go ahead and loot it.
What do we have in here? Anything useful? Got some blammo, some gumdrops. More Sunset Sarsaparilla. Always great. The gun cabinet. A sawed-off shotgun. And I'm over-encumbered. Pop a drink here. Replace it. There we go. Now I can start moving again. Grab some more gumdrops. Some yeast. Caps. And the cash register has some stuff in it. Let's see, what will we have in these ammo crates? 5.56s. I don't have the space in my pack for any of this stuff. Okay. Just, take the stim pack and the flamer fuel. Still got enough space. Gotta take the Nuka-Cola and the stim pack. Leave the other stuff. Really, I keep hitting critical. I mean, I just dumped all my stuff in my hotel room back there. Jeez. Okay, that's everything in here that I need to take. Now, the reason why I come to the El Dorado gas station to make black coffee. Oh, great. Okay, well, I can only make this once, one at a time. Because of the coffee pot. The coffee pot leaves my... I only have one coffee pot. But, I only need one to make the coffee. Okay, there we go. That's, all the coffee that I need. I'm out of Coyote Tobacco Chew again. Alright, I'm gonna head back to Nipton, but, I'm gonna have to go looking for a mod. I think there is a mod, it's called Home Cooking, I believe. That'll allow me to add a hot plate to, so I don't have to come down the road every single time I want to, cook something at a fire. I'll get that sorted out. But, there's a lot more stuff to do back in Novak. I'm gonna take that care of that, next time. Lots of stuff to do out here in the wasteland.